Blackstone Publishing presents A Perfect Shot, a novel by Robin Yocum. This book is read by Richard Ferrone.
To Francis Kennedy, The Irish Rose. Prologue. On May 24, 1994, a warm, clear Tuesday in which the Ohio River Valley was finally shaking off the gray doldrums of a cold and damp spring, the most popular man in the history of Mingo Junction, Ohio, dropped off the face of the earth. Not a single person in that gritty little steel town could explain his disappearance. There were no signs of foul play. No notes or clues were left behind. It was as though the earth had opened up and swallowed Duke Ducheski alive, classic Buick and all. In the months and years that were to follow, there was never one credible reported sighting. His credit cards were never again used. His bank account remained untouched. Simply, he had vanished, and all that remained were unanswered questions. The people in Mingo Junction were heartbroken at their loss. For weeks, that's all they talked about at Wheeling Pit, the VFW, Isley's, Carmine's Lounge, and, of course, Duke's Place, each taking a turn to tell about the last time they saw him. They offered theory after theory, but not one mother's son of them had a substantial clue as to his whereabouts. Everybody had an opinion, but nobody had an answer. The last man known to have seen him alive was the overnight employee at the crematorium. While he enjoyed a brief period of local celebrity, interviewing for the newspapers and the lone television station in Steubenville, he could offer nothing beyond wild speculation. No one wanted to believe what they all were thinking and feared, that the great Nicholas Duke Ducheski was dead. How else could it be explained? His prized automobile was gone. He might have left his troubled wife, but he certainly wouldn't have just walked away from his thriving namesake business. Then came the rumors, ugly and whispered. He had angered the mob that controlled the vice in the upper Ohio River Valley. There was talk of missing gambling receipts, tens of thousands of dollars. It was the only logical explanation, most agreed. The Buick had been fed into a shredder, probably with Duke still behind the wheel. Nothing made sense. As a journalist, I was fascinated by the story. As a blood relative, I was devastated. Duke and I had practically grown up together, and I had long treated him more like my hero than my cousin. Although I was older by just 23 days, he was always bigger, stronger, faster, and a better athlete. And he seemed infinitely more mature. People were drawn to Duke Ducheski. When you were in a room with him, he made you feel like you were the most important person there. He was the kind of guy you wanted to be around. His good friend Mooney Collier often called him Bo Peep because, he said, everyone followed him around like a flock of lambs. His personality had nothing to do with his popularity, though. My cousin was known throughout the Ohio Valley for the shot. On March 20th, 1971, Duke Ducheski made the most memorable shot in the storied history of the Ohio High School basketball tournament. Capping a miracle come-from-behind flurry, Duke launched a shot from the corner that gave the Mingo Indians a victory in the state championship game in Columbus. If he had never done another thing in his life, that would have been enough for the people of Mingo Junction. On the streets of that eastern Ohio community, Duke Ducheski could do no wrong. He was a living, breathing legend. And then he was gone. I found out that Duke had disappeared in the most embarrassing way a journalist can learn of a big story. I read about it in a competing newspaper, the Steubenville Herald Star. On the morning of Sunday, May 29th, 1994, 2 days after he was reported missing by his wife, the Herald Star ran a terse 4-paragraph story on page 5 of the local news section under the headline, Mingo Junction Man Listed as Missing. A Mingo Junction man has been reported missing by his wife, according to a report filed Friday.
We hope you enjoyed this preview. To continue listening to this audiobook on Google Play Books, use the link in the video description.